Hello everyone, welcome to homeschool and we are with the chapter carbon and its compound. We started with chemical properties of organic reactions. As I told you, there are four important chemical reactions we have to study in a chapter. Under that, first one was completed in the last video and we discussed many things about combustion reactions, isn't it? And today we are with the next reaction, that is oxidation reaction. Okay, we are going to discuss about the oxidation reaction, guys. What do you mean by oxidation? You must have studied in the first chapter, chemical reactions and equations, isn't it? So what was the definition I gave you for oxidation reaction? Oxidation is nothing but addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen is called as oxidation, isn't it? So such oxidation reaction you can observe with organic compounds also. Clear everybody? From organic compounds also, we can able to remove hydrogens. Isn't it? Organic compound contains many hydrogens. You can able to remove hydrogen. At the same time, you can able to add oxygen also to the carbon atom. Got to know? And this is what the process, we will call it as oxidation reaction. Okay? Say here, what example we are going to study is ethanol. Okay, you know what do you mean by ethanol? Ethanol, OL means what functional group is there? OH. Okay, so ethanol converts into ethanoic acid. Okay, say you know ethanoic, oic acid in the sense what functional group? COOH. OL means what functional group? OH. Yes or no? Remaining is same. ETH between carbon atoms, single bond. So AN. ETH, two carbon atoms and between carbon atoms, single bond. AN. Okay, but what is the functional group present in this compound, guys? OH. What is the functional group present in this compound, guys? COOH. Okay. See, what is converting to what? OH group is getting converted into COOH. Okay. See difference you see. Here you have a OH. Here you have COOH. That means you can observe in the functional group itself. Say here only one oxygen was there, but here one more extra oxygen has come. That means what? You have added oxygen atoms to this guy. Yes or no? So addition of oxygen is called as what? Oxidation reaction. Isn't it? You observe the oxidation here. And you will clearly understand once I write the chemical equation. Okay. So ethanol converts into ethanoic acid in presence of oxidizing agents. And what do you mean by this oxidizing agents, guys? The agents which helps for oxidation to happen are called oxidizing agents. Okay, so if you want to add oxygen or remove hydrogen, somebody must be there to help here for the organic compound. So who is that somebody helping for oxidation reaction to happen? That somebody is oxidizing agent. Okay, so here you must understand the definition of oxidizing agent also. So what do you mean by oxidizing agent? The substances that help for oxidation to occur or to happen is called oxidizing agents. Okay, so here alkaline alkaline potassium permanganate, potassium permanganate. Okay, so what is the formula of potassium permanganate? KMnO4 is the best example for oxidizing agent. Okay, and one more example is there, that is alkaline potassium dichromate. Alkaline potassium dichromate. What is the formula? K2Cr2O7. You have to remember the formula, guys. Okay. So these are the two different oxidizing agents that we will use it during oxidation reactions of organic compounds. Okay. So oxidation to happen, somebody's help we will take. Who is that somebody? Oxidizing agent. So what examples are there for oxidizing agents? These two. Okay. Now we will write the equation for this conversion. Okay. So ethanol, how do you write the, if the name is given, you must able to write the structure. Isn't it? That I taught you in the previous videos. So how do you write the structure of ethanol? CH3CH2OH. Isn't it? Eth means two carbon atoms. All means OH. Okay. First you have to put the carbon skeleton. Then how many hydrogens are required for carbons? That many you have to put. Yes or no? So this is what we call ethanol. Okay. So this ethanol in presence of alkaline KMnO4. Okay. This ethanol in presence of alkaline KMnO4 or alkaline K2Cr2O7. You know, what is the compound you will get? Ethanoic acid. How do you write the structure, guys? Eth means two carbon atoms. AN, single bond. Okay. Oic acid means what? Functional group COOH. Any one of the carbon itself is present as COOH. Now, satisfy the valency of this carbon by putting hydrogens. This carbon already had one bond. It need three more bonds. So you will put three hydrogens. Okay. So if you are getting confused, hydrogens you can mention this side also, not an issue. But anyway, from starting we mentioned hydrogen in the right side, isn't it? Right side of the carbon. So let us write. So this is what we call ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. Okay, so this reaction we call it as oxidation reaction. So why do we call this as oxidation reaction? Observe carefully, guys. This compound has two carbons, this compound also has two carbons. Okay, but you see here, these two hydrogens we have actually removed. Okay, instead of these two hydrogen, one oxygen we have introduced. Okay, here actually two hydrogens are equal to one oxygen. Okay, see, these two hydrogens we have removed and instead of them oxygen we have added. So hydrogens have been removed, oxygen is added in the place of hydrogen, isn't it? See, that is the reason this is called as oxidation reaction. Okay, clear everybody? So they will ask you in the exam, why the conversion of ethanol to ethanoic acid is oxidation reaction. Okay, so what is your answer there? From ethanol, we removed hydrogen and what we have added? Oxygen is added with the help of oxidizing agent. Okay. So, this reaction is called as oxidation reaction. Okay. And one more question. Carefully think and answer. Okay. Is combustion reaction can be called as oxidation? Oxidation. Combustion means what? Combustion also organic compound reacts with oxygen. Yes or no? Organic compound reacts with oxygen. Okay. So, there also oxygen is added. Here also, if you see, in the reaction, we removed hydrogen and oxygen has been added. So, addition of oxygen is called oxidation, no, normally speaking. So, our combustion reactions also involved addition of oxygen only, to be frank. But what were the products we got there? Carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Okay. So, can we call combustion reactions are nothing but a type of oxidation reactions? Okay. Think and answer to this question. Post it in a comment box. Okay. We will be waiting for the answer. Fine. So, this is all about oxidation reaction. Okay. Fine. We will go for the third reaction, addition reaction. Coming to the third reaction, addition reaction. Okay. The name itself says we are adding something. We are adding something. And remember a point here that addition reactions always takes place. These reactions always takes place for unsaturated hydrocarbons. For unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay. So, saturated hydrocarbons do not undergo addition reactions. Very important point. Saturated hydrocarbons do not undergo addition reactions. Addition reactions. Very, very important point, guys. Okay. So, in the examination, they will ask you, does methane undergo addition reaction? What is your answer? Does methane undergo addition reaction? Methane, saturated or unsaturated? Saturated, no? Methane, it has all single bonds, saturated. Okay, so what I just now told, saturated hydrocarbons do not undergo addition. So, methane do not undergo addition reaction. What is the reason? Because it is saturated hydrocarbon. Okay. So, now let us see what is that addition reaction. Okay. See, I will take an example. This. Can you name this? What is this, guys? Yes. What is this? What is this? I can also write it as CH2, double bond CH2. Structure, what is name of this? Two carbon atoms, yet double bond is there, EN. Yes or no? EN, no functional group, ENE. Ethene it is. It is the first member of alkene, isn't it? First member of alkene. So, to this, when I add hydrogen, okay, in presence of nickel catalyst, nickel catalyst. I'll tell you what do you mean by catalyst. Just try to observe here. Okay. Say this double bond, one of the bond, double bond means two bonds, isn't it? See, one of the bond I am breaking. One hydrogen I will add to this carbon. Another hydrogen I will add to this carbon. Okay. So, what do you get, guys? Now, if I add one hydrogen to this carbon, totally how many hydrogens this carbon has? 1, 2 and newly added the hydrogen. Isn't it? So, what do I get? CH3. And among the double bond, one bond I broke. So, you will have only a single bond. Okay. And coming to this carbon, how many hydrogens does it has now? 1, 2 and 3. Isn't it? CH3. Isn't it? And can you try to give its name? Two carbon atoms, yet. And single bond, so ANE. See, ethene has converted into ethane. Okay, in presence of nickel catalyst. What do you mean by catalyst? Okay, catalyst is the substance that increases the speed of reaction, that increases the speed of reaction. Okay. So, usually whenever you add something to the unsaturated hydrocarbon, the reaction undergoes very, very, very slowly. Just to increase the speed of the reaction, we take the help of certain elements, and those elements we call it as catalyst. Okay, so which is the element that is helping for us to increase the speed of the reaction? Nickel. So nickel can be called as a catalyst here. Okay, so this is what we will call addition reaction. Addition reaction. So whenever they ask you the example of addition reaction, you have to write this. You no need to show the breaking of bond, adding hydrogen here one. That is for your understanding, I explained. Okay, you just write ethene structure plus H2, mention the catalyst and write the product as ethane. Very important example. Okay, fine. Okay, and one more important example here that I will show. Hydrogenation of oils. Okay, what do you mean by the word hydrogenation? Hydro means hydrogen, genation means adding. Okay, adding hydrogen, okay, is called hydrogenation. Clear? Fine. And you know, for our cooking, we use vegetable oils. Okay? And for the cooking, sometimes to make some of the items, we also use dalda. Isn't it? Yes? Imagine your mother is making a sweet. Your mother is making a sweet. Okay? The sweet has to be made with oil or dalda. Okay, either one of them is compulsorily required. Okay, which one will your mother prefer? Bakery people will prefer dalda because dalda is much cheaper than oil. Okay, but your mother will always prefer oil rather than dalda. Okay, at home, in case we have a choice of using oil and dalda, we prefer oil compared to dalda. If you want, you can go and ask your mother. Right now, you can go and ask your mother. Okay, so imagine for making a sweet, which is better one, oil or dalda? Okay, health wise, everybody will recommend oil is better than dalda. Okay, say bakery people and all will use dalda because dalda is available in a cheaper rate. Oil is little costly, isn't it? So my question is, why oil is much safer than dalda? Why can't we use dalda? You can go and ask your mother whether dalda is good for health or bad. She may not be having knowledge of chemistry involved in that, but she will definitely say dalda is very bad out of her experience. So no, she may not know what chemical substances are there in dalda and what chemical substances are there in oil. But out of her experience, out of her knowledge, she will definitely say dalda is very bad, guys. Oil is much better than dalda. Okay, see the chemistry behind that I am going to tell you now. Okay, see, the cooking oil or vegetable oil is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Okay, so usually the dalda will be made from oils only. Dalda is made from oils only. Dalda is not naturally available, guys. Okay, it is always made from some vegetable oil. They will make it from sunflower oil or they'll make it from groundnut oil, whatever may be the vegetable oil. Vegetable oils are naturally available. Yes or no? Groundnut oil, they will extract from groundnuts. Sunflower oil, they will extract from sunflower seeds. Nowadays, they are mixing some other things and all in the oil. Okay. But these vegetable oils are naturally available. We can extract from their source. Okay. Say, as I just now said that groundnut oil can be extracted from groundnuts. Okay. Sunflower oil can be extracted from sunflower seeds. Coconut oil can be extracted from coconut, dry coconut. Yes or no? So vegetables oils are actually more healthy. Why we say not to consume too much of vegetable oil is because nowadays the oils are refined oils. They are to increase their life, people started adding so many other chemical preservatives. Okay, that is why we say oil is bad. Otherwise, oil is good only. I'm seriously telling you, the pure vegetable oils that you extract from their sources, pure sources, is good for health actually. You kept on observing nowadays, coconut oil is good for heart. Yes, groundnut oil is good. Mustard oil is good. Sesame oil is good. You know, they are all vegetable oils. So chemically, the vegetable oils are nothing but unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, so they have unsaturated hydrocarbons, guys. Okay, so what I will write here, vegetable oil. Vegetable oil, any vegetable oil you take, groundnut oil, coconut oil, mustard oil, any vegetable oil. Okay, chemically, what is the chemical component present in them? Unsaturated hydrocarbons. What do you mean by unsaturated hydrocarbons? The hydrocarbons which have double bonds and triple bonds between carbon atoms, isn't it? So they are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, and to them when you add hydrogen, I told you what will happen when you add hydrogen to a double bond, guys. One of the bond in a double bond will break and you know the bond will become single bond. Yes or no? So when you add hydrogen to a vegetable oil, you will get vanaspati. Vanaspati. Vanaspati in the sense, in the common language, we will call it as dalda. Dalda ghee. Okay? And this dalda is a saturated hydrocarbon. Dalda is a saturated hydrocarbon. You, the best example is near, like it's on the board. Yes or no? So whenever you add hydrogen to a unsaturated hydrocarbon, like the containing double or triple bond, it all became a single bond. Okay? So unsaturated vegetable oil is nothing but unsaturated hydrocarbon. When you add hydrogen, it is becoming saturated. And the saturated hydrocarbons are always dangerous. Saturated hydrocarbons are always dangerous. Okay, they are bad for health. They are bad for health. Okay, so why we say they are bad for health? You cannot consume them because they are less reactive in a body. They are less reactive in a body. Okay, so anything that you consume, they should react within a body. React in the sense, they should undergo digestion. Digestion is a chemical reaction, isn't it? Say, the moment you took something, if it is not undergoing any digestion, then what happens? It will be stored as a fat inside the body. Or it may lead to some other disease. Definitely, whatever you consume, that should undergo digestion reaction, isn't it? If digestion doesn't occur, what happens? The food that you took it will be stored somewhere else in the body. And after some time, it may lead to a disease. The same thing happens here. When something is not reactive, it will not undergo reaction, digestion reaction. If it is not undergoing a digestion reaction, it will store as a fat inside the body. That's why I told these guys are bad for health. Who are bad for health? Saturated hydrocarbons are always bad for health because they are not reactive. Okay, they are very dull type of organic compounds. Among all the organic compounds, you know, alkanes, that is saturated hydrocarbons, do not react only. That is why when you consume them, you know, inside the body, they won't undergo any reaction. Here reaction means what? Here reaction means not bad reaction. Here, reaction means good reaction, that is digestion. Yeah? And coming to unsaturated hydrocarbons, you know, they are actually good for health. Good for health. Because they will undergo reaction inside the body. Reaction in the sense, what reaction? Digestion. Since double or triple bonds are there, double and triple bonds are reactive centers in them. Okay, so those double triple bonds are responsible for the reaction. Since those guys are there, they nicely undergo digestion reaction, and once they undergo digestion, out of that, what do you get? Energy you will get. Yes or no? So compared to saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbon, the good guys that we can consume is unsaturated. Okay, so vegetable oils contain unsaturated hydrocarbon. So any pure unsaturated hydrocarbon that is extracted from pure vegetables or, you know, nuts, they are always good compared to vanaspati. That you get it. Vanaspati is artificially synthesized compound. Man is making it. It is not naturally available. How is man making it? He is making it from vegetable oil. To the vegetable oil, he is adding hydrogen in presence of nickel catalyst. So the unsaturated things are getting converted into saturated things, and that is what we call it as vanaspati or dalda. Okay, which is very, very bad. And this is what we call hydrogenation of oil. So questions can be asked of any type. You must able to give answers. You can give answers only when you know the complete concept. Okay, so these are the two examples we studied under addition reaction. Yeah, and these two points are very, very important, guys. Which one undergo addition reaction? Only unsaturated guys. Saturated guys do not undergo addition reaction. But unsaturated guys will get converted into saturated when you add hydrogen, isn't it? Who is more safer? Unsaturated hydrocarbons that is present in vegetable oil is more safer than vanaspati. Okay? Here, everybody. This is all about addition reaction. So in my next video, we will discuss the remaining types of reactions. Okay? Thank you so much. If you like our concept, please like it, share and subscribe our channel to learn it in an easiest way. Thank you.